Ah, Switzerland. Known for its world-class skiing and, of course, its grand hotels. But I'm trying out a different kind of accommodation. A B&B. But in this case, B&B means barn and breakfast. That's right, a barn. I admit, I had my doubts, but it turns out that sleeping in barns is very popular. The Just family is a member of Schlafen in Stroh, which means sleeping in the straw, an association of over 200 farms that rent out accommodations. The price is very reasonable at about $35 a night, and that includes breakfast. The season for straw sleeping is usually March to October during the mild Swiss summer. But because I was here in January and wanted the experience, they made an exception in my case. Now, it gets cold in Switzerland. In January. Real cold. Freeze your off cold. But I was willing to endure sub-freezing temperatures just to see what this was all about. What I won't do for the journal. It turns out that this is only a barn in the loosest sense of the word. At one time, it might have housed a menagerie of farm animals, but today it is more like a small hostel, with a cursory hayloft thrown in to maintain the tradition. It has electricity, but no plumbing or heating. But I had to wonder just who stays in these barns.
There are a lot of families there sleeping here, and many people from Japan, because the Heidi Museum is next to us.
Oh yes, my barn was just a snowball's throw away from the house where the timeless children's classic Heidi was written. They even include a complimentary copy of the book to get you in that alpine mood. After looking around my barn, my colleague who is traveling with me, Andy Jordan, opted to stay in one of the regular rooms the family rents. But hey, give him a break. After all, the guy was on vacation. While my colleague settled into his heated room with a bed and plumbing, I decided to take a look around the farm. Yes, this is a real working Swiss farm, all right. There's a real working Swiss farmer right there. He did seem a little annoyed that I was following him around, shooting everything he did. The cows seemed to take little interest.
This all goes back to the tradition of farmers renting out their barns to travelers, because in the old days, there wasn't a motel every 50 yards like there is now. These days, it's mostly symbolic. I mean, this is the family's actual barn, and I don't know that I'd want to spend the night here. Nothing personal.
And then came the night and the 23 degree temperatures. So out came the blankets. And more blankets. And more blankets. Of course, about this time, a lot of questions come to mind. Like, where does the hay come from? Is there vermin in the hay? Am I going to be brutally savaged in the middle of the night by an angry Swiss cow for sleeping on its dinner? In Switzerland, things close up pretty early in the evening, so tonight I am choosing to do a little light reading and to hit the hay early. Come on, you knew I had to say it eventually.
To be perfectly honest, I didn't think I was going to get a wink of sleep. But once I did fall asleep, I didn't wake up until 6 a.m. the next morning. Breakfast was, I assume, typical Swiss fare. Lots of meat, cheese, and bread. And a special treat for Andy.
Nice quick, I'm so psyched.
Would I recommend sleeping in the straw? Well, no, not in winter. There's a reason why the season is only in the summer. But if you happen to be in Switzerland in the warmer months and need a cheap place to sleep, and you don't mind a little bovine company, then yeah, it might be a good option. For the Wall Street Journal, in Switzerland, I'm Jeff Bush.